In the onboarding, we are going to create an RBAC policy. RBAC is a policy based on roles, admins, editors, viewers, that we can later enforce permissions for these roles in our product. We will start with creating a policy in three steps. Creating a resource we want to protect, defining actions users can perform on the resource, and setting roles and assigning actions to these roles. Then, we will assign users to the roles we just created. And lastly, we will install Permit SDK and see how it all works together. Let's go. For our example, our workspace name is McDonald's. Now, let's create the resource we want to protect. For us, it's going to be a Happy Meal. Now that we have the Happy Meal resource, let's define the actions can be made on the Happy Meal. A chef can prepare it. A waitress can serve it. Customer can order it, pay for it, and unfortunately sometimes even return it. Now that we have the actions, let's set the roles of users that can interact with the Happy Meal. Now it's time to assign users to the roles we just defined. I myself will be your waitress for today. Asaf is going to be the client, and Or will be the chef. Alright, we made it. We have successfully set up an RBAC policy. What we're going to do next is follow the commands and see how permissions are being enforced. First, we're going to pull permit latest version. And we have it already. We're going to run Docker now. We can see my port is not available, so what I will do is just change the port. Alright, now a server is starting up. Let's create a low permissions folder and run npm install express. Let's install permit.io. I'm going to create a new file called test.js and we're going to copy this code to it. We're creating a new instance of permit. We have our user with the proprietary ID. We have the first and last name and we have their email. Then we ask permit SDK to check if the user is permitted to serve a Happy Meal. If the user is permitted, we will get 200, and if we get 403, it means the user is not permitted. What I'm going to do now is paste the code to VS Code. Now I need to change the port. Okay. Let's go back to terminal. Let's verify the file is saved as needed. Let's run it and go to localhost and see what happens. We can see that Osrad is permitted to serve a Happy Meal. Yeah! Let's go back to file and change serve to make a Happy Meal. Save and run it again and go back to localhost and refresh. We see that Osrad is not permitted now. Let's go back to the onboarding and see.
Congrats!
Let's revoke the permissions of the test code and connect our real app.
Join our community in Slack to discuss further and see more tutorials in Permit Doc site.